Hi, I'm Tony Davis, Recreation Program Manager for the Ocala National Forest, and this is Silver Glen Springs, a popular recreational area and archaeological site that was acquired by the USDA Forest Service in 1990. We are interested in balancing recreation and resource protection. To do so, we initiated a watershed restoration project to address the erosion and compaction concerns of Silver Glen Recreational Area.
I'm Ray Willis, archaeologist for the Ocala National Forest. Thousands of years ago, people deposited shell at this site, accumulating massive amounts over time. Much of this shell is a byproduct of shellfish harvesting, but some could be from purposeful construction. The base of this tree, now perched several feet above the current ground surface, shows where these deposits once were. Historically, shell from this site and others like it in Florida was mined for fill material to pave roads. This tree demonstrates how extensive shell deposits once were at this site. Even though much has been removed, there is still a lot to be learned from what remains.
To put today's Silver Glen Springs recreational area, its topography and its heritage into perspective, we can go back to 1875 when Jeffries Wyman, an archaeologist from up at Harvard, visited the site and described it as an amphitheater of shell surrounding the spring boil. In terms of culture history, we now know that Silver Glen Springs was used for at least 10,000 years. In our own excavations across the watershed, we found hints of what we would call either late Paleo-Indian or early archaic settlement. These folks did not use shellfish, and because of that, much of their material culture, all that's left of their material culture are stone knives, scrapers, and lithic flakes. Beginning around 6,000 to 7,000 years ago, we have the beginning of the Mount Taylor period, which is when communities throughout Northeast Florida, including very much so here at Silver Glen Springs, began collecting and depositing shellfish. We also identified at least one, if not two, prehistoric villages lacking shell on the upslope component. In order to document these cultural resources, we used a variety of different techniques and methods, including testing across large areas, including both in the upland terrace, which lacks shell, as well as in the area around the spring. We also used small diameter augers across much of the landform, in addition to stratigraphic testing, so that we could secure radiocarbon samples, as well as samples of vertebrate fauna, so that we could, back in the laboratory, understand what people were eating and what they were depositing on the landform. The hope of this project is that we can do two important goals. One is to better understand how pre-Columbian peoples utilized, experienced, and understood this landscape. And the other is to protect it. And by knowing what cultural resources remain, we're in a much better position to protect these resources.